Hey everyone, it's been a really long time since I made my video about colored flame candles. They're not difficult to make. To put it simply, the most important thing is to choose a compound for the candle body that has a high oxygen content and burns with a colorless flame. It's also important that this substance has a low melting point. Paraffin obviously isn't suitable because it burns with a very bright yellow flame, although adding paraffin or stearin to the body of such a candle is possible. Then you need to choose an inorganic salt capable of coloring the flame and introduce it either into the wick or into the candle body, or both. That's pretty much it. In the previous video, I used dimethyl oxalate for the candle body because it's very easy to synthesize, and it worked quite well, but it has one significant drawback. It sublimes at room temperature. A candle made from it substantially evaporates within a few weeks. Chinese colored flame candles usually use another substance, trimethyl citrate, with various technological additives. So, it's time for me to synthesize trimethyl citrate. I put off this synthesis for as long as I could, because it's incredibly long and tedious. But eventually, I synthesized it. The synthesis itself is quite simple. I took 175 grams of commercially available citric acid, poured in 200 milliliters of methanol, and added 5.5 grams of para-toluene sulfonic acid. It will work as a catalyst. Then the longest and most tedious part began. I boiled the mixture for 5 hours with a reflux condenser. Then I disassembled the setup and reassembled it as a distillation apparatus and distilled off all the methanol. Next, I added 150 milliliters of methanol and boiled it again for 5 hours, then distilled off the methanol again. In total, this last procedure needs to be repeated at least 5 times. So I spent a whole week assembling and disassembling the distillation apparatus. After all that was finished and I had distilled off all the methanol for the last time, I poured the mixture from the flask into water, and after some time, trimethyl citrate slowly began to crystallize out. I left it for a few hours to crystallize. In total, after filtering and drying, I obtained 140 grams of product, which corresponds to a 70% yield. The patent I used promised an 85% yield. So I did get the trimethyl citrate. How does it work in colored candles? Absolutely the same as dimethyl oxalate. I didn't notice any difference. Both give a dim blue flame by themselves, and both, for example, give this kind of green color if a few percent of boric acid is added to the candle body. With lithium salts, the color is orange or crimson. Sodium salts give a bright yellow flame. I haven't gotten other colors yet, but I'll keep trying. That's all for today. Goodbye.